In an 8-1 landmark decision, the Supreme Court has ruled that parents have the right to abort the fetus through its fifth year of life. With me are Mr. and Mrs. Robert Dorsett. They brought this case to the Supreme Court after struggling through the lower courts for 4.5 years. Well, Mr. Dorsett, you finally won. How does it feel?
Oh, great, Susan. I mean, really great. Maybe we can now start living our lives again.
We're very relieved that this whole thing is over.
Go ahead. Tear them all up while you can. You're a dead man, Timmy.
I want it. You hear that, you little prick? Dead.
This has been a very long and costly battle for us, Susan. I mean, all our savings are gone. I've had to remortgage the house, and now I have two jobs. The lawyer fees are going to cost, well over $50,000.
Was it worth it?
Every penny, Susan.
Timmy, shut your mouth!
Let go!
Oh, my God, there
we go. Let go! You're an animal, you know that, Timmy? An animal, that's what you are, an animal! Get in there!
In the only dissenting opinion, Supreme Court Justice Walgren says that he feared for his 3-year-old
life. Don't worry, you're
going to
get it, you hear? You're going to get it, you little asshole! Get it! You're going to get it! You're going to get it!
For Mr. and Mrs. Robert Dorsett, this is a dream come true. For Temmie, well, an ironic note. Tomorrow would have been his 5th birthday. In Memphis, this is Susan Lancaster.
The laughs are nonstop as host Freddie Franken finds another unsuspecting dupe on The Shitheads, Thursday at 8.
Bill Borscht is a special kind of guy. He's a mailman. To some people, delivering mail is just another job. But to Bill Borscht, it's a dream come true. 12 years ago, Bill lost his leg drawing to an inside straight. Most of us would have given up. Not Bill Borscht.
Hey, Bill, did my disability check come yet?
Yeah, I am right here. Hey,
great, just put it in the box.
Hit box.
Yes, to the people on Elm Street, Bill's an inspiration. To the people on Polk Street, he stinks. Fire the handicap. Then nothing but trouble.
Remember this? The sound of metal on metal? A wet towel snapping on skin? A crowded shower room?
All right.
And the satisfaction of a group of men having done something together and done it well. Hi, I'm Fred Dreyer. Do you remember all that? Well, if you do, you're gay.
Tonight, on Educational TV, part one of Alastair Clark's acclaimed British series, Why Do Men Have Nipples?
Do you know me? I was the right-hand man to one of the great leaders of history. I almost changed the face of Europe. I was a man above all other men. But still, people don't know my face. That's why I carry the American Access card. The American Access card. Don't leave home without it. Do you know me?
I love the morning with all its natural fragrances. So fresh, so alive. The gentle scent of budding flowers, the soft aroma of an ocean breeze. That's why I was so pleased to discover Morning Mist Feminine Douche. Now I can feel fresh as morning all day long. Morning Mist in two natural fragrances, rose petal and herring. Morning Mist Feminine Douche.
No time to cook? No problem. Not when you've got Bullseye's new international frozen dinners. Bullseye travel to the four corners of the earth to give your family a taste of the world. This smart mother is giving her son Bullseye's newest international treat. A meal so real you'd swear you were in Biafra. Bullseye, we believe you'll eat anything.
You might not know it, but we own 30% of the world's land and control more than 30% of its population. We're in oil, steel, finance, real estate, farming, all the industries basic to man. We're the owners of the world and getting bigger. We are the Catholic Church.
Sears repaints the Wailing Wall. Details at 11.
Sally Jones opens her mouth for milk. Milk. You can't have too much of it.
Redwoods. The heart of big timber country. These trees are tough, big, strong, 120 feet high, and more than 200 years old. We brought the new 12-pound Mighty Mo to the California Redwood Forest to prove a point. Get the point?
John Henderson opens his mouth for milk. Milk, now in reusable containers.
Hi, this is Johnny Jones, a religious fanatic punished for what he believes, is crucified, and then rises from the dead. Do you buy that? See if our contestants will tonight on...
Hook, Line, and Sinker!
When Grandpa can no longer live with the family, think of us. Because we at Peterson's Retirement Home firmly believe senior citizens never outlive their usefulness. Yes, at Peterson's, we do more than take care of the elderly. We recycle them.
Welcome home, Grandpa.
Peterson's, just like Grandma used to make.
Still a corner of the world where the dollar can buy the luxury of kings. If you desire the elegance of yesterday in a setting as modern as today, come to South Africa.
We'll be waiting for you.
A new breed of hero. Hard Times, 1880. A lawless town, Abilene, Kansas. And a brave man, Dr. Marvin Kittleman. Frontier gynecologist. Wednesdays at 8. We all agree that God created man in his own image. But then, how do you explain the Muslims? This message has been brought to you by the National Conference of Christians and Jews.
I like the sun, and I like the beach, and I like men who look like that. Do you look like that? You don't, do you? And you never will. Do you think this and this and this is going to make you look like that? It isn't.
This message has been brought to you by the Truth in Advertising Council. In this world today, $1 doesn't go very far, does it? Sure, you could buy a couple of packs of cigarettes and enjoy yourself. Or you could feed and clothe this Pakistani family for a month. That's right. Two packs of cigarettes or feeding a starving family. We know you'll make the right choice. The General Tobacco Company.
Action, excitement, and plenty of surprises as funny man Jeffrey Hines is the special guest star this week on Celebrity Hanging! Then, an ecology special. An unusual look at an unusual animal, the last of a vanishing breed. The disgusting world of the puma. Fridays at 7.
When Bill and I got married, the one thing we planned on was having a couple of kids. One thing we didn't plan on was Bill dying. I don't know what I would have done without the help of the good people at First National. Thank you, Mr. Sloan.
Glad we could help. Connie will have her family now because her husband had the foresight to open an account at First National, the nation's largest full-service sperm bank. And when we say full-service, we mean just that. Our friendly tellers are always willing to give you a helping hand. And naturally, we offer all kinds of conveniences to meet your special needs. Easy-to-use night deposit boxes.
What do you mean? I'm overdrawn.
You must understand, Mr. Merlman, you haven't made a deposit in over 20 years.
What about my Christmas club account?
Maybe you should consider taking out a loan.
And, of course, banking by mail.
Hey, what's going on here? I gotta get home.
Come on, man, move it.
No problem is too big or too small.
Mr. Sloan, I'm having a problem here.
Why, that's no trouble at all. Here, let me help.
Yes, for Mrs. Connie Ackerman, for Mr. Alfred Merlman, and even for Rodney LaMunson. First National Sperm Bank is the full-service bank. First National, we're with you for the long pull.
In an age of fads, crazes, and cheap gimmicks, you can depend on Bronfman Memorial Park.
This is a 5-year-old die-tough battery. We're about to put it through a grueling test. For the past 5 years, this battery has not been used. Will it still perform with the dependability needed to carry out this man-sized job? Die Tough. The name says it.
Excuse me, sir. How do you spell relief?
Relief? Relief starts with an R. R-E-R-L-R-L-I-F-F.
Excuse me, ladies. How do you spell relief?
Oh, that's easy. I spell relief. F-A-R-T.
Educational TV presents a 5-part series on the nose. Olfactory blessing or unsightly mess? Part 1 tonight.
Don't miss the Reverend Maurice Fideau's sermon, Man, a Spiritual Assessment. Join the Reverend Fideau and his friends this Sunday on Poodles for Christ.
Yee! Yee!
Caught me.
Let's get going and get him.
That's what we're here for, ain't it?
Yeah. I asked comedian Billy Boggs to join me in Austin, Texas, because I know Billy is equally at home behind the sight of a 12-gauge shotgun as he is on the stage of a crowded Las Vegas showroom.
Oh, it's sure been a long time since I've been here.
Ah, starting to get an itchy finger, eh, Billy?
Oh. Whew. It's a long way up.
Oh, yeah, but I think it's going to be worth it, Billy. Yeah.
Well, it gets tougher all the time.
Well, it was a lot tougher without the stairs.
Whew.
Celebrity Sportsman presents...
Here we go. You ready, Billy?
I'm ready anytime you are, buddy.
Okay, let's go get him.
Live from Austin, Texas, the Charles Whitman Invitational.
Here they come.
Oh. Hey, look at that! I got that letterman! Look at the size of that sucker! He must be 6'5".
Get the one in the yellow sweater over there, Billy.
Clean! I bet you didn't even feel it.
Get the professor!
Oh, that tweed jacket's going home with me. Ow! Oh, good. I didn't even put a hole in it.
Oh, he sure is an old one. Well, that's it, Billy. We bagged our limit.
Oh, no.
This one sure was a beauty.
Huh? Yeah. Well, what the hell? She'd have starved to death anyhow. Job market being what it is.
Hey, look at him. Didn't he something? I bet he'll go 280.
Easy. I swear I never seen a letterman that big.
It was a good day's hunt, and both Billy and I agreed we would come back next year.